What?
My album is on Amazon.com, Amazon.com. Ha 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 ha.
Oh, very nice.
Holy.
Okay. You need that.
Okay, so. All right, I'm about to tweet the link.
And so, what's your favorite thing about the twittering?
That my fans feel close to me. See, they're already tweeting it.
Already?
Mm-hmm.
Wait, how long ago did you post that?
2 seconds ago. I'm number 4 on Amazon.
Number 4?
Yes.
You were just 508.
And then I was 11. And now 11. I'm number.
Wait. Yeah, so how did that happen?
I guess people really went and bought it.
So you hit number 4 on Amazon 6 weeks before your album comes out.
Yo.
I think the collective wisdom about Nicki Minaj is that she's a star. She's certainly the most interesting, relevant female rapper in the last 10, 15 years.
The mortality rate for female MCs is really, really high. We don't have one female MC who's retired rapping the way, say, Jay-Z can retire rapping. But on some of her mixtapes, she's rapping like the best of the boys.
When Kanye West Monster came out, people sort of unanimously decided that she had the best verse on a song that featured Jay-Z and Rick Ross, and this person who people barely know annihilated everybody.
A lot of people know what she looks like. A lot of people know she has a lot of Twitter fans. People know that she likes to sign girls' boobs.
She's one of those few artists that knows what she wants, and she will get what she wants, no question about it.
I want it to look fly, gotta look right, you know what I mean?
She's kind of come to her fame in a curious way by being on other people's songs and by being sort of ubiquitous, but only in a flash. I think people think that she can't make an album. And if the product ends up not becoming what we all hope it will, she could go away.
You can't have buzz this big and have so much media attention and so many captive fans just waiting for your first album and have it suck. I think she needs to show people who she really is, bare her soul just a little bit, just a little bit.
You know, why isn't there a female rapper turned mogul? I mean mogul. Having an empire that lives on beyond your rap career. And so I don't know why women haven't done it. I just know I want to be the first woman to do it, and I will be.
We don't want to change anything through here. Obviously, we'll just.
But look, camel toe. Charlie, unless you think we could pull it out right before I do the present, and they won't notice. What do you think? This is my second fitting for my presenter's outfit, and this is exactly what I wanted. I wanted to do pants. I wanted to do a small top. I wanted to have cute accessory, couple boobs, not too much stuff going on.
I just met him for the first time. What is his name?
Charlie.
Charlie. Charlie.
Charlie is our tailor.
I'm so happy that you have done. Thank you.
A pleasure to meet you.
Thank you.
No, because he did a great job. This, you know, he tightened it. Because earlier today, this was like huge on me. This vest, it was like 3 sizes too big. So he made it perfect, and he made this almost perfect, but he's gonna fix it, right?
I just imagine how your body is. And
you imagined how my body was? You did a great job.
Follow that thought.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Thank you. I like that idea. That's the kind of idea I was going for. Because with pink hair, that might look good. Let me try that on first.
Okay.
Thank you.
And my face shuttle and I'm not coming down. I miss Larry when she's just so monotone. Sometimes it's just me and all my bottles all alone. I ain't coming back this time. At the end,
thanks.
What are you laughing?
Bravo, Diva. Shit.
Quincy, shut up. Would you shut up? No. It's my first ever time performing on the VMAs, and I'm nervous.
Why are you nervous?
Because I know people can't wait to bash me. That's what they do. That's their job. Another day.
She likes to come to the studio 10, 9 o'clock in the morning, like business hours. She don't do that late night studio, because it's like when 10, 9 o'clock comes, her brain just shuts down. She's just like, and just falls asleep anywhere.
You know that song that I was working on for Drake?
Yes.
Could you pull it up?
When we first come in, if it's not 85 to 90 degrees, we can't walk in the room. It has to be hot. And then she gotta always have her cranberries and almonds. If we don't got cranberries and almonds and some waters, we gotta fix that ASAP.
Are you getting all my cranberries and almonds? And I hope you made your own plate.
Yours is right there in the back.
You're getting your own now? I have to tell Carter about it. You don't get your own cranberries and almonds. Mute that whole lead. Let me just get a new high lead on the second half. Let me see if I can get a better.
Definitely focused, like everything is straight up, dealing with all the beats, making sure everything is straight.
Well, can you confirm that Rihanna has the Pro Tools?
Mix everything.
Bring the just a half a dB down.
Dealing with label.
It's not every moment I want to be like a freaking cartoon, you know?
Dealing with artists.
So, to work with you, you're so...
Yes.
She's just as much on top of the business as she is being like a regular artist.
You should have it already. I think I sent it to you.
No, you didn't send me. You sent my engineer some horrible girl trying to re-sing it, and then you told him we'll cross that bridge when we get there.
Come on, Nick. All right, let me figure it out. I'll call you back in a minute.
All right, thank you.
All right, bye.
I can't believe what's happening here.
Why?
Cuz you should just be making hot.
I wish I could just make music and not worry about anything. That's what I say all day. I wish I could be one of those artists that just go to the studio and just like everything else, they don't deal with it, but I'm not. I deal with everything. I have a calendar in my brain, and sometimes it just overwhelms me because I want to just focus, but I can't.
Stuff is getting me bogged down. I'm sad.
I'm scared.
Scared of what?
Failing. I wasn't happy about my BET Awards performance. It's kind of been haunting me forever since I did it. People thought I lip-synced and I didn't. To know that I didn't lip-sync and I really gave it my all, and then after I had put all that work into it, that's what people were saying. I felt really, really upset. It's given me this paralyzing fear. This is definitely the biggest moment of my career. Today is like Roman's revenge.
Here we go, Scam Art!
I do think this is a blessing to live this life if this is what you genuinely want, but I do believe that there are hundreds of millions of people in this world that if they got a taste of this for 1 month, they trade it. They trade it all.
I need to hear it. We only have 5 minutes. We only have 5 minutes and we're not going to be able to run through the show and the sound period before the show.
Well, we need to do that again so we can alter.
You saw what happened with BET. You saw what happened. I'm not going to embarrass myself. Guess who's not on camera? You. You can't make a mistake. I know everybody pays for their mistakes, but no person, when they make a mistake in their life, when they answer to family and friends. But an artist, it's like, you have to answer to the world. Did anybody come calling us yet?
No.
Okay.
Ready when you are. What?
Excuse me. So they called us?
They're ready.
Did they call us?
They didn't call you, but they're ready for you when you come out. Well, they're going to go get Will, and then they're going to come get you.
Just answer the question, okay? Please don't play with me right now. No. Just, no, that's it. Please. Let's not, please. Or nothing. I've been told forever that you're not gonna sell. No one's gonna get you. Don't sound too smart. You can only be a part of a crew. And I just know that there are so many women that get told these things every day. I used to think that this was all about me. But I'm not doing it for me. I'm doing it for them.
Welcome back to the 2010 VMA pre-show. Nicki Minaj is about to have her first live solo performance. Ladies and gentlemen, give it up for Nicki Minaj!
When you start affecting lives, you have more of a responsibility. You know, you're no longer doing it for you.
How are you?
I'm good, thank you so much.
Or if you're still doing it for you, you're just a selfish person.
Thank you, Mama, you too.
I look like a true lunatic right there. Our show today, can we go? From the bottom of my heart, I wanted to thank each and every single solitary one of you. This day is one of the best days of my life so far since I've been doing music because I actually feel comfortable with my team and I'm proud of myself, but I'm proud of you guys.
Thank you, girls.
You guys bust your time and time again. And sometimes I don't realize.
We're here. I'm good.
We love our Black Barbie.
Everybody comes up to me after we do things and say, good job, and you did it, and you did it. But we did it. We did it. We did a good job today. And I realize the sacrifices that you guys made. And I love you. Because you're my family. So when I yell and when I scream, it's not that I don't like you, it's that I'm nervous. I don't want to fail. I have so many blessings, but the biggest blessing that I have right now in my life is my team. Anyways, that's it. Thank you.
A while back, you and me were in a car driving to the VMAs, and you said that if most people experience this life that you live, that they would trade it. Would you trade it?
No. No.
Hip hip hooray!
Hip hip hooray!
Hooray!
Let's sit down, you guys. We need to do a good family portrait.
How long has it been since you guys have seen Nikki?
About 6, 7
years. Stop, man. Get in the picture. I'm going to be mad.
I guess my question is who is Roman?
Roman is a crazy boy who lives in me. And he says the things that I don't want to say. He was born, just a few months ago. I think he was born out of rage. He was conceived in rage. So he bashes everyone. He threatens to beat people, and he's violent.
That must be nice to have, like, an ignorant loudmouth who you can just sort of blame every...
He wants to be blamed. I don't want to blame him. I ask him to leave, but he can't. He's here for a reason. People have brought him out. People conjured him up. Now he won't leave. Like, my brain doesn't compute. Now I write rap. It doesn't. You just have to now let it happen and just don't second guess yourself too much, and then it gets done. You need a job. This ain't cutting it. Nicki Minaj. You ain't cutting it. Little rag rock. I shoot with a padlock. I shoot movies. Camera block. To me, music is like spiritual. So it moves you in like a weird way that you cannot teach in school. I'll hear a beat and words just start coming to me.
I am not Jasmine, I am Aladdin. So far ahead, these bums is lagging. See me in that new thing, bums is gagging. I'm starting to feel like a dungeon dragon. Rah, rah, like a dungeon dragon. I'm starting to feel like a dungeon dragon. Look at my show footage, how these girls be spazzing. I look like getting back to a has-been. Yeah, I said it, has-been. Hang it up, flat screen. Plasma, hey Nikki, asthma. I got the pump, it ain't got medicine. I got bars, sentencing. I'm a bad, I'm a, and I'll kick that punt. For trauma, blunt. You play the back, I play the front. You need a job, this ain't cutting it. Nicki Minaj, who you ain't f***ing with? You little frag of rock, beat you with a padlock. I am a movie, camera block. You out of work, I know it's tough. But enough is enough.
Yeah.
Yo, does that sound normal to you?
Let me hear the whole thing from the top, all right?
I got bars. Sentencing.
When everything comes together, you feel like this is my castle. The world is my stage, you know? Feels like I'm in control.
Like a dungeon dragon. I'm starting to feel like a dungeon dragon. Look at my show footage, how these girls be spazzing.
So what was your early life like in Trinidad?
I lived with my grandmother. And there were a lot of people that lived there.
Oh my God! Hi!
Maybe 10, 15.
Oh
my cousins and aunts and uncles and stuff.
Oh my God.
And then when I was really, really young, maybe like a toddler, my mother left. Both my parents left. So I was left with me and my brother, and we were with my grandmother.
God,
I don't want to get her like a look-alike Nikki.
I don't want to act like Nikki in front of you guys.
I want to see the Nikki.
Serious, honestly.
How long has it been since you guys have seen Nikki?
About
about six, seven
years ago.
Yeah.
Grandmother died.
Yeah.
I came once before the funeral and I spoke to Granny and she said, the next time you see me, I'm gonna be in a box. And I said, don't say
yeah,
that.
Yeah.
So and sad, the so next bad. Time I saw her, she was in a box. That was the last time we all came together. Everything in Trinidad reminds me of my family that is no longer here.
Did your grandmother ever get to see you perform? Do you think your grandmother would be proud of you right now? Of the woman you became?
A lot of times when you're from the islands, your parents will leave and then send for you. Because it's easier when they've established themselves, when they have a place to stay, when they have a job. I thought it was gonna be a few days. It turned into 2 years without my mother.
What did you think New York was gonna be like? How did you imagine it?
I thought it was gonna be like a castle, like, you know, white picket fence. Like a fairy tale. And I got off the plane and it was cold. I remember the smell. I could always remember the smell when I got out of the airport of the snow. And I had never seen snow. I remember the house. I remember that the furniture wasn't put down. The furniture was like piled up on each other and I didn't understand why, because I thought it was gonna look like a big castle. I started hearing a lot of arguing and I didn't know why. I was always very nervous, very afraid. So I knew that wasn't normal. My father would yell and curse a lot. It was right in the crack era. We didn't know, but he fell victim to crack shortly after he moved to America. You know, when you're on crack, you can't keep a job. And when you can't keep a job, you don't have money. And when you don't have money, you steal. And you steal from your family.
Come and see this. Come and see this.
You steal from your wife's pocketbook.
But I do have sneakers, and I want to know what size you guys wear.
And you steal from, you know, you'll steal your son's video game.
Anna, can this fit you? What size you need? It looks so cute on you.
How was your mom surviving all this?
My mother was the strength. You know, she kept us together. She made ends meet. She always kept a job. She always kept her head held high, even when she was really, really embarrassed, you know.
And this is a 7. I wonder what size you wear.
I'm going to see if this one will fit me.
If you don't get one now, I'm gonna get them later on tonight, so don't worry about that.
Yes, sweetheart, I'm not worried at all. Nikki's in the building.
Well, let's just say I have furniture now. You know, I have furniture.
Okay, so how many vehicles we got and exactly which van are we going in? We're going to the mall. Hopefully we won't cause a big problem. We got some stuff that you want. If you want some stuff out of there, you want some stuff out of there? Don't feel like you have to get one. Just get whatever you want.
But you got stuff?
Can you get a whole bunch of stuff for her? You need a D cup or like a double D, don't you?
Oh, you went all out, huh?
Get it. Why don't you try both of these ones and see if it can fit?
Nick, who's paying for all these clothes?
Me.
Why are you doing this?
because I love my family very much and I want them to have whatever they want.
Why are you crying?
Because I love her.
Why are you crying? Over here, you
crying? I'm not crying. No, 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 I'm not crying. I'm happy.
Forgive us if we sinned against you. Cover each and every one of us with your protective shield. Father, give me wisdom on that stage and give me power and courage. Bless the people there tonight. Let there not be any chaos or violence. Let everyone leave happily.
Yes. What's special about this one?
It's my homeland.
Has your mom seen you play live?
No. I don't want her to. There's just certain things I wouldn't say around my mother, you know, just out of respect.
What are you expecting?
You wanna know what's so crazy? I don't really have any expectations. Mm. I don't know. I don't know what to expect.
Oh. Safari, get the girl with the yellow shirt.
Hello there.
Hi, babe.
Hi.
How are you?
Good.
Do you wanna take a picture?
No.
When's your birthday?
Yeah.
How old are you gonna be?
16.
Happy birthday.
When you're young, it's easy to feel trapped. It's easy to feel like you're not understood. That's why we always say, you don't understand. And I'm like, I understand. That's why I'm here. Give us a blessed show and performance. And let us not have any regrets after tonight. In the name of Jesus, amen.
Amen.
I don't even know. I was like in a trance for the whole time.
How do you feel?
I feel great. It's a superb accomplishment. I was so happy to see them dance. How far is this room that we're walking to, James? It's too long. I can't. My feet hurt. Where's my slippers? James. Sorry, can you give me my slippers? Who was it? Don't play stupid
with
me.
No,
seriously, I'm gonna slap.
Nobody.
Really?
Really?
So it's a joke? It's a joke?
It's a joke. It's a joke.
You really? You is 911. I always gotta jump up and do when I always do everything people want me to do. 911. I rush in, do everything. But when I need to do for me, it's a different story. Out of here. And I said, if you do that to me, I'm going to double and triple charge you. I'm not going back on that because I'm fair with everybody, and it's up. That's ego's getting in the way. But when I have an ego, I'm a bitch. So I'll be that. You walk around this game with the biggest ego, you can't tell me. But when I stand up for myself, no. No. No way.
What just set you off?
I feel like there's someone that I did something for, and I feel like when it was time for them to return the favor, they wanted to be on some different and I really can't talk about it. Like, but I just feel like, okay, you was on your different shit, but now you need me again. And now I'm supposed to just drop everything and... No, I'm not dropping everything no more. I'm doing a album and people is calling me, could you put a feature on this? Could you know, and I'm doing it. But it's a lot of artists that when they doing their album, they shut down. No, don't call me. Don't ask me for shit. You have to be like a beast. You have to be a beast. That's the only way they respect you. I came up under Wayne, and Wayne has his way of doing things. When Wayne walks on a set and say, don't talk to me, have my music ready, get the up out of my face and I'm gonna blow this to your face all day, it's cool. But every time I put my foot down and stand up for myself, it's like, we've heard about Nicki Minaj. Nicki Minaj shut down a photo shoot. Oh my God. Everyone's, no one's wants to work with Nicki Minaj. I'm glad you heard. Now, when I come to a photo shoot, let it be of quality. You know why? Because I put quality in what I do. I spend time and I spend energy and I spend effort and I spend everything I have, every fiber of my being to give people quality. So if I turn up to a photo shoot and you got a $50 clothes budget and some sliced pickles on the board, you want to know what? No, I am going to leave. Is that wrong for wanting more for myself, wanting people to treat me with respect? But you know what? Next time they know better. But had I accepted the pickle juice, I would be drinking pickle juice right now. When I am assertive, I'm a bitch. When a man is assertive, he's a boss.
Bossed up.
He bossed up.
Yeah, he bossed up.
No negative connotation behind bossed up, but lots of negative connotation behind being a bitch. Really, for real, don't touch me. Willie, do not touch me. Willie, stop. No, for real, stop. You're embarrassing me in front of a whole bunch of people.
What's going on? Why are you upset?
Do you not realize that I'm at my video set and I can't push this back? I'm not like you. I don't sit home and hang out. Do I need security to escort you up? Because I will escort you if you try to play me like on my video set. Like, I'm dead. Yeah, because I'm not.
So you want me to stay 2 more hours just like that?
Is there a problem? Because I'm here working. This is called a job.
Okay.
You thought we were really arguing, right?
We'll just keep doing little pieces of this.
Okay, all right. Here, Diane. I mean, sorry. Just take this, let me go.
Okay, guys, anybody and everybody who does not need to be in this set, step to the other side, please. Thank you.
Acting is very important to me. I'm an actress first, and I don't want to be rapper turned actress. That's not who I am. And so, to me, it would be a slap in the face to every actor I've ever worked with in school and all the teachers that I've learned from if I made a mockery out of the
out of the craft.
All right, so let's just work with, we were with working, making her laugh. So I want you to just chase her around the room for a second because I want it to be difficult.
Find a way.
Find a way.
Why are you like this? You can watch my eyes first.
I went to school at Performing Arts High School, LaGuardia, in Manhattan in New York.
And do you remember your audition?
I was hoarse, and I kept thinking, oh my God, how am I gonna sing? I had a singing audition and an acting audition.
So you attack and you defend. When I say switch, then you attack and you defend. And action.
I went and, you know, I did my singing. I failed miserably. I was defeated. I said, forget this school, this stupid school. I don't want to be here anyway. Get me out of here. And my mother was like, no. And then I had to do my acting audition.
Don't play stupid with me.
No,
seriously,
about.
I'm going to slap
nobody.
Really? So I have to look through your phone and show you what
I saw? Yeah, you can do
so
that.
So it's a joke? It's a joke?
When I started doing the acting audition, I felt right at home. I knew this is what I wanted to do for the next 4 years in high school.
Feel comfortable? Right through you, so go right into it.
I think that's what defines a true leader, a boss. It's being able to bounce back. I think it is important that people do know it's not easy. Nothing is given to you on a silver platter. I got fired from like 5 waitressing jobs, you know, then I went into being a customer service rep and, you know, being an office manager, and then, you know, got fired from all of those. But throughout all of those jobs, I was still just taking one lead after another. I mean, I've been led down a lot of dead-end roads. But for the last 10 years of my life, I've been telling people, I'm gonna make it one day. Watch, you're gonna see me. And I definitely think this is it. I mean, this is not only thing, but this is the beginning. I am on a road to doing something that's like that's bigger than me.
So, are you playing the role of a rapper right now?
I don't know.
Is this an audition?
Maybe. Maybe I was just auditioning to see if I could kick everybody's ass, and then I'll, you know, gracefully bow out and say I'm done, next role. Next script.
Donald Trump can say, you're fired. Let Martha Stewart run her company the same way and be the same way. Oh, evil. But Donald Trump, he gets to hang out with young and have 50 different wives and just be cool. Oh, Donald, we love you. Donald Trump. But when you're a girl, you have to be, like, everything. You have to be dope at what you do, but you have to be super sweet. And you have to be sexy, and you have to be this, and you have to be that, and you have to be nice, and you have to... It's like, I can't be all those things at once. I'm a human being. I don't mean to be ranting and raving like this. Don't use this footage, please. It's just gonna make me look stupid.
Okay, last question. When are you happy?
If everybody asks me that, that's why I'm laughing, because maybe I give up the impression that I'm never happy. People see me as like, it's all fun to them. But, you know, I think the biggest problem is that people think this will always be their moment. And that's not true. I feel like at any moment, if I don't pay attention, that not only I can lose everything, but my family can lose everything.
Liam, child, it's you.
You know, my little brother, he was so small when I met him. And I could see his whole body and his whole face. He was this big.
Right this way, nephew.
And I remember his eyes. They were so big and bright, like this. And I remember looking at him like, your crazy little lamb chop. What are you doing here?
This is the rate of interest that has been agreed to with you in the bank. This is the mortgage. Again, we're going to initial every single page.
I think I wanted so much for him, and now I'm in a position to do those things for him.
This is what ties the loan to the property. Basically, it says as long as you make the payments, it's yours, and you can live there happily.
Yay! Pat on at home,
Congratulations.
This is for my mom, actually. This is not for me. This is for my mother and for my beautiful brothers.
Today is a very, very great day. I can't say anything more.
I'm not happy in the club. I'm not happy in the movie theater. I'm happy when I'm doing things that I never thought I could do, but that I prayed that one day I would be able to do. You know, I remember recording my first song and thinking, it's never gonna happen. It's never gonna happen. Cut to, you know, 20 songs later, and it's like, yes, haha, can't wait. But don't get it twisted. It's not about money, it's not about the fame, it's about, I don't have to worry if my little brother is gonna be able to get a new toy for Christmas.
So you want your room to be red and have a black carpet. I think that's a good idea. So let's mark it. You have a marker?
It's those little tiny things, they really make up the bigger picture. So my happiness doesn't come from money or fame.
Honey, why did you have to write it so big and obnoxious?
Because getting paid moves.
My happiness comes from seeing life without struggle.
Awesome. Put exercise room. What? No, put gym on here.
I came to win, to fight, to conquer, to thrive. I came to win.